Hi everyone, in these first few videos, I'm gonna show you how to make 4 space-themed science experiments. These are all science experiments from my first Stay Curious and Keep Exploring book. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make magnetic slime, something I like to call space slime or meteorite slime. You'll learn why in a second. So get your magnets ready because I'm gonna show you how to make slime like you've never seen before. If a meteorite fell in your backyard, how would you know that it was a rock from space and not just a regular Earth rock? Meteorites fall to Earth all the time. After all, that's what most shooting stars are, meteors that will ultimately fall to Earth and become meteorites. But if one of those happens to land in your backyard, how could you check to see if it's from another world? Well, I happen to have a meteorite right here. In fact, I have a bunch of them because I gave them out as party favors at my wedding. And if I didn't already know that these were meteorites, I could just check with a magnet. We can see that this Earth rock is not magnetic. This one is not from space. Why are meteorites attracted to magnets? Well, it's because most meteorites come from asteroids, and most asteroids have a high percentage of iron in them. Iron is a special type of metal called a ferromagnetic metal. This means that it's attracted to magnets, and under the right circumstances, it can become a magnet itself. So, if you found a rock in your backyard and it happens to be attracted to magnets, you may have found yourself a space rock. Now, get off. Come on. Now to make magnetic slime, or space slime, or meteorite slime, you need a few things. I'll link all the materials in the comments. You need glue, baking soda, water, iron filings, contact solution. Make sure it's the kind of contact solution that has boric acid in it. And finally, you need a magnet. In a bowl, mix 1/3 cup white glue. Mix 1/4 teaspoon baking soda. The recipe. 2 tablespoons of water. 2. Mix that up with your spoon. Now add 2 tablespoons of your iron filings. Oh gosh. Okay. Well, it's okay if you add a little more. 2. Now mix it up. Finally, 3/4 tablespoon eye contact solution. This is what makes the slime turn from really runny and flowy to more viscous and slimy. Just like that, you've made your slime. Now, let's see why we call this meteorite slime. Because just like the meteorite, this is attracted to, metal spoon, also attracted to a magnet. Let's try that again. Because just like a meteorite, this is attracted to a magnet. And it's attracted to the magnet for the same reason that a meteorite is attracted to a magnet, because of the high concentration of iron inside. Whoa, it's like it's coming alive. Oh! Go, go, go. You can see like the little itty bitty iron filings working to get to this magnet. Are you kidding me? Whoa. Why was that so much fun? Did you know that one of the best or easiest places to search for meteorites is in a large barren landscape like Antarctica or in the middle of a desert where the surroundings are very light, so these are easier to see. But also if you found a dark rock in the middle of Antarctica, there's a good chance that rock came from somewhere else, maybe space. Thank you so much for doing science with me today. Stay tuned for many more science experiments. And as always, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time.
Gosh, this is so cool.
Oh. Stay tuned for many. Oh my gosh, I think I just got that in my mouth. Yuck.